In this video, we are going to see about the encoders. In the previous video, we have seen decoders. So encoder is a reverse of or the inverse of the decoder. Where in decoder, what we do is here, n inputs are there and 2 power n output will be there. So if you are having, say for example, 2 to 4 decoder, that is 2 inputs, and 2 power 2, so 2, this will be considered 2 variables, and this is enable signal. Okay, so when you have 2 inputs, these are all the inputs, and this is additional, you can say this is a power. So when this is 1 only, these 2, whatever input you are giving, that will have its effect. So here when there are 2 inputs, then 2 power 2, just nothing but 4 output will be there. Right now, that's what we have seen. So when there are 3 to 8 decoder, 2 power 3, that is 3 inputs are there. So 2 power 3 means 8 output. So based on this combination, if it is 0 0 0, then Y naught will be on, and whatever is connected to that, that will that particular circuit will be get connected. So if it is 0, 0 and 1, let us take 0, 0, 1. That is, sorry, here, 0, 0, 1. So in the case, Y1 will be on. Okay, this will be enabled. This Y1 will have an output of 1 in this Y1. So all the others are 0. Okay, so like this. Take here. So this is what we have seen in the decoder. Already we have seen this. Now, we are going to see encoder, which is the reverse of decoder, where there are n inputs and 2 power n output. Whereas here, 2 power n inputs are there and you have n output. So for example, see like this, 2 power n input lines are there. So for example, if we have 2 power 3, imagine. 2 power 3 input, which is nothing but our 8. Okay. The output will be 3. Here, n input lines, 2 power n input lines and n output. So here you will have 3 outputs. Whereas here you have 8 inputs. Right. So that is what, it is the reverse of decoder. Now we'll see how it works. We'll see with an example. 4 to 2 line encoders. Here 4 to 2, that is 4 inputs are there and you will have 2 outputs. That's what? See, 2 power n means 2 power 2, which is 4. And you have 2. Here we put substitute 2, no? So 2 output lines. So here 2 output lines are there. So when if you see the truth table, why not? Let us take for this output. This is a combination 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So when it will be 0, 0, we have to check from here. When it is 0, 0, 0, 0, and 1. Okay. 0, 0, 0, 1. The output which comes in these two lines are 0, 0. Okay. This is the output. Now, when 0, 0, that is 0, 0, 1, 0, then this will have the combination output as 0 and 1. Okay. Now, same way, when 0, 0, 1, 0, then you will have 1, 0. When 0, 0, that is 0, 0, 0, and 1, you have 1, 1. So, if any one of the input is on, so for example, if it is y naught is 1, okay, when y naught is 1, you have the output as 1 bar. When y1 is 1, then you have y1 is 1, then you have 1 and 0. So any one of the input only will be enabled, right? And depending upon the which line is enabled, you will have the output here. So if you see the output, if we write Boolean equations for this, We check for the ones. Now for A1, we have Y1. Okay. And then here also one, we have Y0. So Y1 plus Y0 will be the output. Then that is equation. For A0, for this, when you take the ones present in the output, you have to check for ones in the output. So here if you take Y2 and then Y0. Okay, so this is the Boolean, respective Boolean equation for this. Now we'll go for octal to binary encoder. Now octal to binary, the name itself say 8 inputs and to binary. So that is, so it is 8x3 encoder. So 8 inputs are there, right? And we have 3 outputs. This 2^3 is 8. Now if you see that combinations, D7, D6, all these things are given. So at a time, only one will be on. So for example, if it is D0 is 1. For example, if it is all are 0, then D0 is 1. Let us say this is 1. That means the output is 0, 0, 0. Then if it is D1 is 1, see here, D1 is 1, then the output will be 0, 0, and 1. If this is 1, okay, you will have 0, 1, 0, and so on. So at any point of time, only one input will be enabled, and whatever the input line, respective input line is selected, you will have the output in all the 3 lines. Whether it is a 0 or in the combinations, you will have in the output. Now, the implementation of circuit, whatever we have seen the previous. So, how we are going to implement? For this, you have to check the number of ones. If you see this, x, what is the value of x? Okay. So, here if you see that, we have D4, then here D5, D6 and D7. So, that is what given here. Same way for y. For y, it is D2, D3, and then D6 and D7. See, D2, D3, D6, D7, and so on. So likewise, that also you can find. Now, if you draw the circuit diagram, it will be like this. So all these are inputs, D0 to D7. Here, since D0 is not at all occurring in this, no need to connect that. So if you see that there are three X, Y, Z, three equations, three variables. So X, Y, and Z. Now we can connect it accordingly. We have to connect D4. For X to be on, you connect it to D4, D5, and D6, and D7. Likewise, you connect the respective. And when you switch on, that is when you give input for those things, you will have the respective output. The next one we are going to see is decimal to BCD. The previous one we have seen octal to binary. Now we'll see decimal to BCD. So when I say decimal, it is 0 to 9. And BCD is the 4-bit output. Okay. So 00 to 1001. That is what BCD. The BCD is different from binary because binary, it is called binary coded decimal. So from 000 to 1001 only will be in BCD. After that, it again starts from 00. So it is, even if it is binary, it is similar to 0 to 9. That is our decimal. Okay. The representation will be 0 to 9 only. After this, again, it will be like this with the more number of variables. So now we'll see decimal to BCD encoder. So it can give only up to 4 bits representation. So now Y0, Y1, Y2 up to Y9. These are all the inputs we have given. And these are the output. Okay. So from 9, so when there are how many values are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 values are there. So a 10 value can be represented with, since it is more than 7, that is 8, 0 to 7, above 0 to 7. So since we, if we are able to represent 8 and 9, then we have to go for 2^4. It is not 2^3. If it is 2^3, then it is softer. It is 2^4 now. So what we do is, since it is 2 power 4. So it is 2 power 4. You can represent up to 16 combinations, but we don't need all those 16 combinations. Okay, we need only 4, because 0 to 9 only we are going to represent. That is what BCD. BCD is nothing but binary coded decimal. So here, when why 9? See, let us take the combinations. When why not? When this is 1, you will have the output 0, 0, 0, 0. So it will represent the first output. Then when y1 is 1, it is for 1, numerical value 1, how you will write? You will write 0, 0, that is 0, 0, 1, 0. That is 0, 0, 1, 0. That is what here we have written. Okay. So for y1, it is, if it is 1, then you have 0, 0, 0, 1. That is 0, 0, 0, 1 for 1. For 0, all are zeros. Okay, for y2, if this is equal to 1, then you will have, you will represent 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, which is equal to decimal equivalent of 2. Okay, and binary equivalent is this. Same way for 3, it is 0, 0, 1, and 1, and so on. You can see this for y3. When this is enabled, you will have the output like this. Okay, so this combination is there. So up to 9. So when this is y9 is 1, see here, when this is on and all the others are 0, then you will have 1, 0, 0, and 1. This will be the output. Now, the logical expression for this is, you have to check for 1. So when you check for 1, you have these two, A3, which is nothing but, see the respective row, y8 and then y9. So that's what we have written. If it is A2, then this is nothing but y4, y5, and then y6 and y7. Okay, and so on. You can check for y1 and a0. So wherever the one is there, that respective row combination, row and column combination has to be taken, and that variable is represented with addition. So this is what, using this, you can implement a decimal to BCD encoder. So here, whatever we have seen in the previous, that is, this equation is what we are implementing in the next, that is in this picture. So we have represented A0, A1, A2, A3 to be this combination. So this combination is nothing but our previous, this equation only we are representing it there. Okay. So Y8 and Y9 will give A3, A2 is Y4, Y5, Y6, and Y7. Like this. Now we'll see how actually this encoder and decoder are used. Now, if you see this, both are combined here. An 8x3 encoder with a 3x8 decoder. So 8x3 encoder, 8 inputs are there. And for 8, you will have 3 outputs, right? And here 3 to 8 means 3 inputs and you will have 8 outputs. Suppose I want to select the 5th line. Okay, this. So what will be the output? If I am going to select this, the combinations will be 101. Now this is what I am giving as an input for this decoder. Now what will happen? It will select this. So here you select I5 and you will be able to select the output 5. So this is the way how you can combine both. The next one, what we are going to see is priority encoder. The priority encoder is an encoder circuit in which inputs are given priority. What will happen? The previous one and the previous encoder, what we have seen is at a time only one output will be, that is any only one input will be in a high state, and the respective output, that particular combinations will be, you can see in the output. That is what we have seen. So at any point of time, only one input will be having the high value. Suppose more than one or having high value. How to handle it? So for example, I naught is also 1, I 1 is also 1. So how to handle that situation? That comes the priority encoder, because any one only has to be selected. So how you will select? Whether I naught, selecting I naught, you will have this. If you are selecting I 1, you will have the output like this. So which will come, whether 0, 0 or 0, 1. So in the case, we are going for a priority encoder, where this is a block diagram given, I0 to I3. And then we have this V also that I have not shown here. But anyway, V is also, this is nothing but enable. Okay, these are all the output. Since we are going to see a 4 to 2 priority encoder, I have 4 inputs and 2 outputs. Now, at any point of time, in the previous encoders, what is the rule? Well, if I0 is 0, this will have 0, 0. If I0 is selected, that is 1. If it is value is 1, all the others will be 0 and you will have 0, 0. If it is 1, if I1 is selected, all the others are 0 and you will have 0 and 1 and so on. When I3 is selected, that is this is 1, all the others will be 0. Input will be 0 and you will have 1 and 1 as the output. This is what we have seen in the previous encoder. Suppose this is also 1 and this is also 1. How to tackle that situation? So that comes our priority encoder. We have one more extra signal called V, or E you can say, enable the priority encoder. So if it is equal to 0, whatever may be the input, don't care. Okay, whether this is selected, this is selected, this is selected, or this is selected, whatever it is, don't care. Output will not change anything. Now, suppose this is enabled. Now the priority encoder is enabled, and now it acts upon the inputs, various inputs given. See here, priority is given from lower to higher. Let us imagine this is having the lowest priority and this is having the highest priority. So when I0 is lowest, I1 is having more priority than I0. I2 is having more priority than I1 and I0. I3 is having more priority than I2, I1 and I0. Okay, so what happens when I0 is 1? And this is, let us imagine this is 1. Okay, so leave it. Now I0 is 1. So when all the others are 0, when I0 is 1 and all the others are 0, then naturally this will be considered. So 0, 0 will be your output. Suppose I1 is 1, okay? Then even if it is 1 or 0, that is why here we have given a don't care condition. X is considered as a don't care condition. So whether it is 1 or 0, even if here it is 1 is there, I0 will not be considered. Only this will be considered, because of the two, only this has more priority. That's what we have seen. This arrow mark shows the priority range from I0 to I3. Okay, so even if this is 1, this will not be considered, since this is set, this has more priority. So the output will be 0 and 1. Now see this, I2 is set. So here, whatever may be the condition, whether it is a 1, both are 1, that will not be considered. Only I2 data will be considered, input will be considered, and you will have the respective output as 1 and 0. Now when this is 1, I3, which has the highest priority, so even if it is 1, 0, whatever it is, those values will not be considered, and more priority is given to this, so that output will be 1, 1. That is what I have written here. Okay. So far we have seen that encoder. We will see about the multiplexers in the next video.